Sensors are in something we touch multiple times a day, every day, even right now, probably. How do they really work? What do they look like? You cannot have AI without sensors.
Hello, I'm so excited for our guest today. Today we have Tiffany Zabinski, and she is coming to us from our Plymouth, Michigan facility, not too far from the Detroit area. And Tiffany, I know you're working in sensors, right? But could you introduce yourself for all of us?
Yeah, sure. Hi, guys. I'm Tiffany. I am an application engineer and a customer project leader for MEMS sensors. My customers are primarily in North America. But I've been with Bosch for my entire career. I started as a co-op during university. Once I graduated, I haven't left. I am a Bosch for life.
That's great.
So in the past, I was a calibration engineer. Then I was an application engineer and a resident engineer. Then I moved to Germany, and I had a five-year assignment there. And that's when I joined the MEMS sensor group, and I dealt directly with the development of MEMS. Hmm. And once I came back to Plymouth, you know, I kept the same role. I'm currently the only customer project leader that's outside of Germany.
Yeah, that's very unique, right?
I'm still working with my team in Germany, but I also get to now be here and be home, essentially.
Yeah, that's great. Okay, so you casually mentioned MEMS sensors, but what does that mean?
Yeah, so MEMS sensors is micro electrical mechanical system. That's what it stands for. And it's a tiny sensor that's smaller than your pinky nail. Yeah, it's very small and can even be smaller. And it is connected in things we interact with. And it's in our daily lives. So it's in machinery, in your smartphones and video game consoles and automotive. And the MEMS sensor is sensing or detecting these change in motion, in tilt or rotation. And then it sends these signals to a central controller. And the central controller then makes the decisions. What will they do next? Hmm. So like an automotive example is airbags. Airbags are in all of our vehicles. Airbags save lives. And MEMS is a part of that. So the MEMS sensor can detect if there's a crash. So it's this change in motion, and it sends that signal to a central controller. Then the central controller can decide, will I deploy the airbag or not?
Right. Wow. I'm just like thinking about how big of an impact that is in such a small package. It's such a good visual that I keep looking at my pinky nail because I'm like, okay, what? You know, that is responsible for potentially saving my life, you know, in a car crash. That's amazing. It seems like as a non-technical person, and I know a lot of our audience is not super technical, I hear so much about sensors and it can be overwhelming to realize that they're in everything and what are they really doing? And that automotive example is so good. And sensors, it sounds to me like they lay a foundation for everything we're doing, advancing technologically as a society, and just like things like the Internet of Things, IoT.
Yeah, sensors are still a building block in IoT. You really need that to start that foundation. So IoT, when I'm thinking about it, it's like people being connected to things. So people being connected to buildings such as smart homes, or people being connected to your car. So you want to virtually start your car or lock your doors. You know, you're doing that through your phone.
Right.
And then there's also objects talking to other objects, like your oven is talking to your vent hood, and it's sending signals to automatically turn on the vent hood because there's too much steam or because things are too hot.
Right.
So the MEMS sensor is really helping in all of those steps to help make that happen.
Yeah, that's so interesting because you don't think about those those details, you know, often we're just like so quick to be like, okay, that's great. My eventhood went on, you know, on to the next thing. But yeah, there's so many different things behind the scenes. Like, it's one of those things I feel like the MEM sensor doesn't get enough credit, you know?
Yeah, I'm, you know, people will say sensors and it's really a broad spectrum, but MEMS sensors are very specific and you really do need that as your starting point.
Yeah, yeah. That automotive example is so tangible for me because it's, you know, most of us are either in a car or driving a car probably every day, mm-hmm. or if not, at least surrounded by cars. What about, do you have any other examples of maybe how we're using sensors more than we realize?
Yeah, so sensors are in something we touch multiple times a day, every day, even right now, probably, you know, our smartphones. We use our smartphones all the time. Maybe you're listening to this podcast on your smartphone and you want to have directions to the next hot restaurant and you're following your navigation and you make a wrong turn or you get off at the wrong ramp. The MEM sensor can detect these things and then it sends the message to your navigation, which then can reroute you.
Oh, yeah. That's when the voice comes on.
Yeah.
We all know
recalculating.
That. Recalculating.
Or, you know, you're taking your selfie and you're moving your smartphone around. You're trying to do like portrait and landscape modes. And you can see the screen rotating automatically. And that is a MEM sensor detecting a change in your orientation. And it's sending the signal so that your phone can adapt. So really, everything we're touching, everything we're doing every day.
Yeah, that little magic sensor behind the scenes, I swear, you don't think about it, you know? So as we talked about sensors and kind of supporting IoT or the Internet of Things, can you share a little bit about how IoT or sensors are impacting our world and what you think the future looks like with that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I think it's really difficult to avoid IoT. Because it really is surrounding us. It's everywhere in our daily lives. And, you know, our grandparents are using smartphones.
Right.
And it's also helping connect people from the most remote parts of the world stay connected. And that's amazing. But I also think it's really difficult for people to keep up with this rapid change of IoT.
Mm. I agree. I think it can be overwhelming. And sometimes there's an element of fear sometimes with change happening so fast, you know, and like you said, kind of keeping up with it. It's interesting, though, that you bring up like the generation, the grandparent generation. I find that so interesting how, you know, as a kid growing up, I looked at my grandparents like they didn't know what they're talking about. That's what you picture of your grandparents.
As
you know?
A child, yes.
Yes, but now it's like, seriously, sometimes I'm talking to people much older than I am that know more technology than I do, you know, or they're, and I'm just, it's just amazing to me. And I mean, it has such positive influence and impact too. Like you said, the not only the remote locations keeping people in touch, but also like access to, you know, help for people who need a little extra assistance.
Right. And that is MEMS technology as well. Having that SOS that is becoming a common feature in phones and in cars. And that is MEMS that's also helping send that signal so that you can have an automatic SOS, automatic help. You know, it's not just in things we touch, but how to help make your life more convenient.
Can you talk to me a little bit more about the future of sensors and IoT and AI? What does that look like in the future and with sensors involved?
Yeah, so really in an attainable future, in our future, we have the fully automated driving. Mm-hmm. We already are seeing some snippets of this where it's partially automated, but you know, fully automated is coming in our future, and where you really need MEMS sensors as that base, as that building block to assist these other features in the car to make sure that you're driving in the lane and straight and that you're not drifting. or that you're safely stopping, or that you're predicting a collision. Mm-hmm. You know, MEMS sensors are the building blocks, and you cannot have AI without MEMS sensors.
All the size of your fingernail. I'll never look at my hand the same way again.
Yeah, even smaller. Some of them are much smaller than your fingernail. Your pinky nail.
Wow. For those of us that are intrigued, or maybe they have a good base, but they want to just kind of understand more, do you have any recommendations for resources or what they can do to kind of dive in themselves?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so YouTube, there are a lot of Bosch videos about MEMS sensors. So how do they really work? What do they look like? What does the inside look like? Mm-hmm. And all these moving parts inside. And there's quite a few examples on YouTube. You can also go to the Bosch Global website and search for MEMS sensors.
Okay, great. Yeah, I'll link that too in the show notes so people have a quick access.
Great.
Yeah. Okay, well, this has been so good and so helpful. And I always like to ask our guests about the best piece of advice they've ever gotten as just a little way to wrap up.
So I have two.
Okay.
So the first is to take charge of your own career, because nobody's going to do it for you, and to network. Mm. So constantly network and have a diverse network group.
Oh, that's good. Yeah. Well, thank you so much. This has been wonderful. Thank you for coming in and
Thanks
sharing with
me.
Us.
Yeah, it was great. Thank you very much.
Thanks for listening to Beyond Bosch Podcast. In case you missed our other episodes, now's your chance. Go back and take a listen.